Rabbi Zalman Lewis is an Orthodox rabbi who runs a local Jewish student center and serves as Jewish chaplain at Sussex University. He's come to talk to me about Purim, a Jewish festival, and how it is celebrated in Brighton. Hello, Rabbi Lewis.
Hello, Yael. Thank you so much for inviting me to join you here today.
Happy Purim.
Happy Purim to you. I don't usually walk around with this hat, but in the spirit of Purim, there's a little bit of fancy dress.
So tell us about the spirit of Purim then.
Absolutely. So Purim is very much a joyful festival, a festival of happiness where we dress up in fancy clothing and fancy dress and celebrate it in commemorating the miraculous salvation of the Jewish people 2,500 years ago from a wicked Haman.
Right.
Where we read the story of Esther from the scroll of Esther. We have an original scroll here, and here in Brighton, local synagogues last night and this morning will have read the scroll. And in fact, every time we mention Haman in the scroll,
you have to make a big noise.
You have to make a big noise and bang out and drown out the name of a man who tried to destroy the Jewish people.
Shall we have a go, for
and
a sec?
And thankfully was defeated. Yes, we can do it.
Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely.
So this has been going on in Brighton today?
Yes, last night and today here locally in Brighton, local community, synagogues, Jewish nursing home, Jewish students, people right across the town have celebrated Purim by reading the scroll of Esther. This is a handwritten scroll and commemorating the festival in the wonderful way in which actually is written in the scroll that we should commemorate it, which is firstly to read the scroll of Esther, as well as to do three other things, to have a feast. In fact, many people interpret that as to actually get intoxicated, have a couple of glasses of wine.
Right.
Only time in the Jewish calendar year.
You're supposed to get drunk, no? You're actually told to get drunk.
Yeah, thankfully, I'll be doing that after the cameras turn off.
Right.
Another thing that we do is we give charity. And finally, the fourth thing that we do in honor of Purim is that we give gifts of food to one another in order to celebrate the miraculous salvation and the miracles that happened.
I actually saw on social media this morning a research fellow at Sussex University posted that he's going to give the parcels of food, the Purim parcels of food, to the wider community, to homeless people around Brighton. I think that's wonderful that there's a cross-community charity
as well.
Yeah,
absolutely, and the fact that, you know, that relates to charity, really binding the two themes together, the charity and the gifts of food together, a very thoughtful idea.
So you're a rabbi, obviously you're a very religious person. Brighton is largely secular, the Jewish community in Brighton is largely secular. How do you engage people in celebration, Jewish celebration, especially the students that you work with? How do you engage them in the various festivals today, especially?
You know, reaching out, making events that they can relate to, but also taking the timeless messages of the Scroll of Esther. You can read a scroll and you can feel as if it's something dated from 2,500 years ago and not really relevant today. But the truth is there is actually so much in the scroll that provides meaning and purpose and pride for who we are as wherever somebody might be from any walk of life, in a very, very powerful and very relevant way. And to communicate those messages to young people, as you say, is for me actually a very meaningful exercise, to be able to sit with young people and communicate to them that Judaism can be relevant and we can take the messages from a scroll that's written exactly as it was 2,500 years ago.
Wonderful.
And relate to it in a very powerful, meaningful way. In today's day and age, it's very, very powerful that somebody can walk around in a city like Brighton proud to be a Jew because 2,500 years ago,
Haman
was defeated.
Thank you very much, and happy Purim.
Happy Purim.
Thank you to Rabbi Zalman.